Welcome to another week of YouTube, where we're getting some winter preparations kind of underway. Granted, winter is a long ways away, but we do have an opportunity to finish some projects that we didn't complete during the summer. The wolves have done their winter preparation as well. You can see here a full winter coat on Grizzer, and that is certainly something that makes them a little warm on these October days when we might get temperatures in the 60s, and you see them panting a little bit there. Also put on a little winter fat, and Grizzer's got a little bit more than we want. Denali needs to gain a little bit more fat prior to winter, but that's the challenge that you have when you feed wolves a large quantity of meat, and it's up to them to decide who gets the most. And so recently Grizzer has been a little bit more aggressive on food, where prior to prior to September, Denali and Aiden would always eat first, and Grizzer would kind of stay back. And now that Grizzer is transitioning into a dominant role, he's becoming more aggressive at the carcass and certainly guarding and keeping the other wolves off the carcass, including Maya, which is quite interesting. So the wolves actually have been fairly calm this week. We're seeing, again, a little bit of testing behavior from Denali, a little bit of charging behavior on Aiden, but overall not too much going on. You can see a little posturing here. Denali is trying to hold eye contact with Grizzer, and Grizzer just continues to ignore him, and that seems to work best for Grizzer. And Denali's actual testing has really, really decreased a little bit. Again, you see him trying to confront Grizzer, and Grizzer's really taking it in stride. There's not really any serious aggression coming from Grizzer. He continues to hold his tail in a dominant posture and would soon ignore Denali whenever possible. That's easier said than done, especially when a wolf follows behind you and tries to bite your tail does four-leg stabs and tries to engage your contact. But overall, Grizzer's taken it in stride, and he actually is quite a laid-back personality. One thing that is apparent in winter is obviously activity increases. That was Aiden just running down the hill, followed by Maya, followed by Denali and Grizzer. And actually, that wasn't so much Maya going after Aiden as much as some activity on the outside of the enclosure. Basically, they came from the wood line, panicked Aiden a little bit because Maya came running down the hill and ran up the wood line, and we're looking out the fence line. It was probably a wild animal on the outside of the fence. By the reaction of the wolves, it could very well have been a wolf. That is most likely what's going to cause them that kind of heightened excitement towards the edge of the fence line there. You see Grizzer kind of still standing there sniffing the air a little bit and just kind of patrolling the fence line. That is something that we deal with here more in the wintertime. Wild wolves who may be loners, who may not be part of a pack, that may not be feeding with a pack, will smell the deer or beaver that we're thawing here and certainly be drawn in to the extent, not so much that they're living on our site, but they may pass by. And wolves are always there, regardless of whether we have deer or beaver or whatever. Wolves are always passing through the area, but they might come a little bit closer to the fence line just because of that scent. And again, that only happens once a week when we feed, and we were just getting beaver out about when we filmed this. So we see, we talked about this before, an interesting relationship with Aiden and Grizzer. Aiden certainly does respect him. Aiden is very timid or submissive towards him, whereas Denali, and you can see here again, Denali tries to hold Grizzer's gaze, and Grizzer just averts his gaze. He gives him a little sideward glance there and just says, by communicating through eye contact, that he's not going to engage in activity with him. And again, that's something that's going to have to work out. Denali's going to have to either accept that he is not going to go anywhere in this pack structure with Grizzer. In other words, he's going to stay second-ranking male, or there's going to be a more serious test on Denali's part. Denali is young. He's 2. He doesn't have the confidence, really, to probably push it much farther. But we do know that Grizzer has the power to stop it. And so that's one of the things that we're, training people to, who work here and who see the wolves on a frequent basis, is to really watch some of that tension. All right, so that's about it. And now we're going over to retirement. As usual, Shadow is scraping the ground, doing some marking. Malik's investigating ravens. He is obsessed with ravens who fly and land on the edge of the fence line. We did get a dead raven out of the pen the other day, probably Malik's kill. As preparation for winter, we are draining. We did drain the pond in the retired enclosure. Thanks to some creative investigation by the retired wolves, the drain cap is missing. So that means, you know, we usually had a cap that kind of slowed down the move of debris down the pond drain, and somehow they mysteriously took it. Somehow underwater, they took it. So the cover to the drain is gone. That makes for a large suction sound, and that's what you heard there. The concrete block was actually protecting the drain cover, but apparently didn't do anything. They seem to have gotten the drain cover without it. We discovered that when we drained the pond. We, again, didn't see them take it, didn't see the cover anywhere in the enclosure, but wolves can't be trusted, even at the age of 10, to not mess with something. So hence why everything is in concrete and rock, and there's not a piece of material down there that's not usually bolted in or blocked in. So here's Malik again investigating the bottom of the pond. It is a little bit dirty. It needed to be cleaned, and one of the reasons why we drained it is obviously winter's coming. It's colder. We don't want these older animals to be in the water and then have some stiff joints, and they hadn't been going in for the last couple of weeks anyways. It had filled up with leaves, and it was getting a little algae filled, and so it was time to be drained and time to be cleaned. So again, Malik, we had been treating or continue to treat him for a little bit of that abscess tooth. You can still see some of the discoloration on his cheek. One of the issues that we have is it is a little weepy, and so when he sleeps, he'll get pine chips on the scar, and then, of course, we're trying to clean those off, and those make for it to open up again. And so he's got a fairly large discoloration of the skin. But again, we're on antibiotics and hoping that heals up soon. The other thing we've talked about in the past is Shadow seems to have dug himself a little den hole. This is the first time we've actually seen him go into it. We weren't certain how big it is, and now we can see that it'll fit a full-sized wolf. And he actually goes in and is able to lay down or turn around and face us. It does have a little root problem. He needs a little bit of work excavating those roots. He actually gets his leg stuck on the way out from those roots. And so we helped him out today during wolf care, and we cut those roots out of there. So now his enclosure should be nice his den hole should be nice and easy to access. So that's about it, again, for winter preparation. We know that a cold front's coming in this weekend. There could very well be some snow. We don't know when. It's not likely to stay very long, but that is always an option. So it's good for us in wolf care to start picking things up, and you never know when you'll see the ground again in northern Minnesota. So thanks for watching, and we hope you have a good winter transition yourself. Thanks.